Hi, welcome to Naresh IT. This is Kishore and we are going to continue the exception handling in C++. Okay, the major difference between C and C++ is C language doesn't supports exception handling, but in C++ we are having exception handling. Now, first of all, what is called exception handling? In last session we have discussed whenever any particular problem is raised, exceptions are going to show you the solution for the exceptions, that means causing problems. That is why in by using exception handling we can give the solutions for commonly getting errors, okay, commonly getting problems. Now, we are going to discuss in this session how the exception handling is working. Okay, already I have given in C++ we are using try block, throw and catch to handle the exceptions. Okay, in C++ we are using three types of keywords. One is what? Try. Another one is what? Throw. Another one is what? Catch. Actually, try contains the exception causing problem, means the error giving code which is written inside the try block. And throw block, what it is going to do? Throw is going to throw some value whenever that error is occurred. Now, catch block is doing what? It is going to receive that message thrown by the throw keyword and it gives the suggestion or response to that thrown value. Okay, that's why try block contains error causing code, throw is going to throw some value, catch is going to catch that value and it is giving some response to that error. Like this it is working. And another important thing, whenever a value is thrown, program is going to jump to where? Catch block. That means in between that throw and catch block, whatever the statements you have declared, they are not going to be executed. That's why here the important thing is, whenever an error is thrown or an error throw is occurred in our program, now it is going to catch by the catch. Now what happened? In between the throw and catch, whatever the lines we have declared, they are not going to be worked. Means program directly jump to catch, and after catch any statement is there, it is executed, otherwise it is going to close. And important thing is, the catch should be declared after the throw block, okay, means try block, after the try block. When the try block is completed, immediately you have to start related catch blocks. Okay, and now I will show you how this one is working. Okay, in this example how the exception handling is working, just watch it. Okay, first of all, common header files means what? iostream.h and conio.h. and in previous session we have discussed that, okay, Turbo C++ 3.0 doesn't support exception handling. From 4.5 version we are having exception handling. That's why I am going to conduct this example in Dev C++, how the exceptions are working in Dev C++. For that, first of all, common header file hash include iostream.h. okay, first of all iostream.h is required. Next one, conio.h, common thing, hash include conio.h. okay, but here there is a problem. What is that? Actually we are working with the Dev C++ environment. Here we are working in Dev C++ environment. In Dev C++ what happens means, for C++ header files there is no need of .h, it causes error. That's why don't use .h, remove the .h. okay, now only iostream, that's it. But conio.h belongs to which one? Actually it is C header file. That's why here conio.h, and conio.h not compulsory in Dev C++, because of generally in C++ to clear the screen and to stop the program execution temporarily we are using getchclrsr like that functions. But in Dev C++ they are not required, that's why this one also optional. Okay, now I am giving the try block, throw block and catch. Okay, how they are working, see this. Suppose main program started, void main. Okay. Next, here I am going to write the thing. What it is? First, suppose try. Okay. Try block never contains parentheses. Directly you have to open the brackets. Later, in try block, you have to write the some code. For example, see out before throw. Okay, before throw slash in. Now it is the statement I want to print on the screen before using the throw one. Okay, and now watch it, see out less than before throw. Okay, now it is printed as it is on the screen. Later I am going to write like this. Okay, simply throw, for example, one. Okay, now I am going to use throw one. Now the see out after throw, it is another statement in this program. Okay, now here the try block closed. Okay, watch it carefully. Here it is the try block, and first see out is having before throw, and after that throw one, and after that see out after throw. Next, we have discussed that every try block contains one catch block. Okay, now catch block, and the catch block should be followed by the try block. That means after closing the try block, you should have to start the catch block. Now in catch block, what it is going to throw? One. Actually, one is what? Integer value. Generally, one is a integer value. That's why here throwing value and catching value both should be identical. Now int x, for example, x. And inside the x, I am going to write some message. See out less than x is thrown or x is printed. Now slash in. Actually, x is going to receive which one? This thrown value. Thrown value is what? 1. That's why first 1 is printed. Okay. Later see this, what I am doing. Here I am going to close the catch block. Okay, only one line message and the program is going to be closed. After catch block, now I am going to do one more statement. See out, thank you. Okay, now the program closed, means main function also closed. Now what happened? Just watch it program carefully. Now program execution starts from main function, but here one important thing you should have to remember. When void main is there, your dev C++ compiler gives error, because of in dev C++ either main or int main only allowed, but we have started what? Void main. That's why remove the void and place int. It is another important rule. Next, not only that one, actually it is not turbo C, already I have said that it is dev C++, and in dev C++ the regularly used object like C out to C in, they belongs to std namespace. That's why whenever you are working with C out C in our program, compulsory you have to use using namespace std. Otherwise what happened? Suppose you are not using namespace std, what happens? No problem. But every time before the C out and C in, you should have to use std colon colon. Here std colon colon, here std colon colon, here also std colon colon, here also std colon. Means 4 times you have to repeat std colon colon. To avoid this problem, just use like this, using namespace std. And one more thing observe, in this example, any CLR SCR is there? No. Any getch is there? No. That's why conio.h, I said it is not required. Just remove it. Now remove this line. Okay. Now clearly declare the using namespace here. Okay. Now the problem is solved. No? Then using just namespace and std. Now that's all. Now what happened? Now your compiler is going to use this namespace. Which namespace? Std. And std is a namespace or container which contains our regular objects like cout, cin, like this. Okay. And now when it is there, there is no need of std colon colon c out. Otherwise you should have to write std colon colon c out only, then only it is working when using namespace std is not mentioned. Okay, it is the rule, but we have mentioned this one, that's why std colon colon is not required. Okay, now how this program is executed? Suppose when this program is executed, every C or C++ program execution starts from what? Main function. Okay, now directly it enter into try block. Already try block contains what? Error causing code or throw statement. Now directly I have entered first before throw. Okay, suppose it is our screen. Okay, it is our screen. First which statement is going to print? Before throw. Okay, before throw is going to print on the screen. Next slash n is there. Now when slash n is there, what happened? Next line. Next, now throw keyword is working. Now throw is going to throw what? 1. Now that throw value 1 is going to received by catch. That's why this catch is going to receive the thrown value 1, that is going to store in x. That means 1 value stored in x. That means this statement executed or not executed means it is not going to executed. That's why I said whenever throw statement is occurred, okay, remaining lines are not executed, program is going to jump to the catch. That's why in between the throw and catch means lines are going to be missed. That's why this line not executed, directly comes to here. Now what happened? C out x. X already received what? 1. 1 printed is printed. That's why before throw and later 1 is printed also. Now once again what? Now the catch block completed, no? But this statement is where it is after the catch block. I said what? Before the catch statement, any statement is there, it is going to miss, not the next line, no? That's why here it is going to print. That means thank you. After 1 is printed, now it is going to show thank you. Okay, now the main block is completed, execution also finished. It is how the try block, throw block and catch block are going to be executed. Okay, it is how the exception handling is conducted. Okay, thank you. Thank you for watching.